Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Bitmain Antminer APW7 12 volt 1800 watt power supply. We will study this power supply. What is the configuration of the circuit? In the first step, we will draw its block diagram. In upcoming sessions, we will discuss each section with details, how the circuit is configured, and we will discuss all possible faults and their troubleshooting and their solution. Input line, ground, line, neutral, three wires. This wire is ground wire, earthing wire. Then these two lines are entering here, line and neutral, fuse, first EMI filter, second stage. Then this power supply will reach to bridge rectifier. After bridge rectifier, it will reach to DC rail. In between DC rail and this section, there is also another subsection, that is PFC section, that is voltage booster. When power supply will maintain at this rail, DC rail, then this power supply will start. It is standby power section. When it will start, it will produce different type of voltages. The first power supply, that is its own VCC for this IC, and it will apply power to line area components, that is this PFC controller. It is in live area. And second power supply, two sections, that will produce power to secondary side PWM controller and fan and pulse transformer driver stage, line, neutral, earthing. Line and neutral will reach here in protection, EMI. In protection, there is overvoltage protection, fuse and EMI. This AC line will reach to rectifier stage, rectifier, filter, and the same stage, will work with PFC controller. The same rectified voltage will reach here and these will be boosted, and then voltage will maintain here, DC line. So we can say AC will enter in protection area to protect this circuit from external interference or any type of switching noise to reach back on the AC lines. So it is a barrier. Rectified voltage are reaching at this stage. When it will start, at that time it will boost. If it will not start, the rectified DC voltage will reach here. From this line, DC line, we will receive DC voltage. There is standby power section, that is this portion. Transformer, IC and its related components, optocoupler, rectifiers. It is standalone power supply. It will turn on and it will provide VCC to this IC, that is here. Then this power supply will turn on fan and it will also provide power to secondary side PWM IC and pulse transformer network. This is secondary side PWM IC. It will provide signal and this signal will be amplified. Then this signal will be switched from this small transformer, that is here. This bidirectional signal will be passed through this pulse transformer and pulse forming network here. Gate driver components will give a special shape to drive these power transistors, MOSFETs, IGBTs, whatsoever we will see in detail. Here is half bridge driver, resonant inductor and power transformer. in the output stage here, there is synchronous rectifier. So pulse transformer will drive power switch and these will drive power transformer. These positive voltage will reach here and it will provide output. In the output, we have rectifier, synchronous rectifier, rectifier and filter. Here is positive, negative, and these voltage will reach here as a voltage feedback over current, over voltage, OCP and OVP. Over voltage protection, over current protection. Basically, over current protection is in primary side. That is this current transformer, CT here. Voltage feedback will be sensed here, line and neutral. And the best troubleshooting facility here, that this power supply contains test points. Because this power supply is conformally coated, so these test points will enable us to identify the faulty area. Line and neutral entering here to this EMI circuit and different class Y capacitors connected between line and neutral, line and ground. This line from first stage inductor, EMI filter, then capacitor, then this supply will reach here at these two points. It is reaching to bridge rectifier. We can see input voltage here, then input stage of bridge rectifier. So if TP3 and TP4 are giving good voltage, that means there is no problem in primary stage. It is 54B65. It is NCP 1654. Marking is 54B65, the original number NCP 1654. It is power factor controller. So this IC will drive its MOSFET or IGBT from here. And then this voltage will be rectified, and after that this voltage will reach to these capacitors. Two capacitors on the DC rail, and in between this line there is surge protection area, that are these two components, NTC and this relay. In the startup phase, this NTC will come in line of the charging circuit so that it will control the current. When this power supply standby section will start, at that time this relay will turn on and it will bypass these NTCs. This is relay driver area, it will drive this relay. And then the voltage will pass directly to the capacitors at full rated current. Here is ICE2QR4765. ICE2QR4765. It is resonant power supply offline switcher. When rectified voltage will reach here, this power supply will start working. This IC will start switching so that this transformer will provide output voltage. Now if you see rear side of this standby section, this is drive area, primary area, and this is output rectifier section. Here is also TP, test point. This voltage will power on this IC as a VCC voltage, and the same rectified voltage will be provided to power on this section. This IC, we can say, when this standby section will start, At that time, this voltage line will turn on this IC. It is PFC controller. Same way in the output side, secondary side, there are two windings, 1 and 2. Here is one diode missing. So these two lines will provide voltage at these capacitors and fan connector J8. So this line, 12 volt section, will power up these ICs. Secondary side PWM controller, fan 7688. It is resonant converter controller, secondary side, and it is also providing synchronous rectifier control, TPHR 8504. So these power MOSFETs will be controlled from this IC. And here is IX4424. It is MOSFET driver. These will drive this transformer. This secondary side PWM controller will provide drive signal to drive these rectifiers. So synchronous rectifier drive will reach here and it will drive these MOSFETs. And we will receive output here at these capacitors, these output points. So this is the block diagram of this power supply. In upcoming session, we will discuss each section with all possible details. And we will discuss cold testing, live testing, possible faults, and their rectification. I hope this video is informative for you. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.